Hello viewer, welcome back to Artistry. My name is Tirus Wanyoike. Today we are here with some power tools. We have some hand tools. We have some pieces of wood. And we'll see a little bit of how to handle these tools, how to handle these power tools, how to use them. Since we are in the workshop and we are doing it practically, we have now to demonstrate on how to do it. Now, before me here, I have two pieces of wood. You may require to fix a piece of wood somewhere or even on such a piece of wood. Many of us will take a nail and a hammer and then we'll just do it. It's one way of doing it, but there is a smarter way of doing it if you have access to such machines as the power tools. But if you are not keen on so much on what you are doing, it's something temporary, then you are allowed to use the hammer and the nail and just to hit, taking care you don't split the piece. But now I want us to see how we can fix this piece of wood on another one. You may be required to put a picture rail in your room, and it might be a wooden partition. So you may need just to screw the piece into the wood part. So we will learn now how to go about it, how to pilot for the, to put the pilot hole, and then we screw it. So this piece of wood, I will pilot it first. Pilot means I will use a small bit, and then it will make way for the screw in the first part of my joint. And that first part means this piece of wood. So I'll drill through it, get a pilot hole, and then from there, I will use my battery screwer to screw this screw into the other part. So the screw thread will hold on this part, and then the screw head will hold on this part. And that way, we'll have a maximum grip. So we have different bits that we can use to drill. They are defined in millimeters. So this one is a little smaller than this. So I'll look at my screw that I intend to use. The screws are also different in their diameters of this part here, the threaded part. So I'll look at the screw and then I can measure it, determine which pilot bit to use, and then I will use it to pilot this part. So I want first to use this small one. So the small screw will be better piloted using the smaller bit. So I'll measure it practically and say, I can put it up here and then see that this is a 3 millimeter thread here. So the length here is about 40 millimeters length. So it has a 3 millimeter diameter thread. So I'll use this bit. This bit is 3 millimeter and it will give me a very good pilot hole. So I'll use my battery screwer. I'll fit the bit in front here. I'll tighten it well, and it is tight. Then to avoid injuring my piece of work, I can even put it this way so that the bit will go into the space once it is through with drilling. Then I'll drill it completely straight from up here. So the control here, I'll put it at 2. Because I'm drilling, I need more speed and less power. I don't need a lot of power. I need speed so that I can go about it slowly. And then I turn the other side and do likewise. I'll drill. Then I have 2 holes. And at the center, I may measure or just approximate depending on the on where the hole is supposed to be. I have 3 pilot holes. They are through, even on the other side. So with this now, you can be sure that my screw is going to be very tightly fixed on this one, because it will not hold so much on the middle part here, which may provide some resistance to the screw. It will grip tightly now on this one. So I'll reverse a little bit my clamp so that I can get it right where I want it to be. Tighten it. Can use another clamp as well to be very sure it is tight. So my work is now well clamped. My work is well clamped. Now I'm ready to move. I make sure here it is flush well. It's flush well. Then I open this bit. I can either open it by hand like this, or I can still use the mortar. The mortar of the machine, I reverse it, and then I hold the front bit here a little bit, and then press the power switch a little bit, it will open, and then my bit will be loose. I'll remove that one, and now fit this other bit. This bit is used now for screwing. So it is different from what I drilled with. There are different ones. This is an engineering bit. It has it has been well shaped to remove the shavings using these provisions. And then this one will be used to screw. So it has two points. You can either use this part, and once this one is done or it has been overused, then you can use the other bit. So there's like two in one. So two in one, then it will give you a long service. It will be worth the money you are investing in it. We used previously to have one with only one side, and now we have these ones that have two sides. So once this one is over, you can use the other one. So I'll just fit it here, just like any other drilling bit. I'll fit it, make sure it is tight. I can tighten it even with my hand, or even use the power motor to tighten it in the front, or rather in the clockwise direction, and then I'll hold it tight, and then I'll move my switch this way now, because I'm screwing, and then I'll use my switch to control the machine so that I can regulate the speed. I don't want to overscrew, and then I'll use the torque adjustment here. Here it is now full torque, so I'll reduce it. It has that clicking sound as it moves, and then I'll limit it to somewhere around 5 or 6. 6 will be good enough for this screw. With time and with experience, you'll come to know what torque fits which screw. So the screw is right here. I'll hold it and place it in that position. Now it's ready for screwing. I'll make sure my part is flush in the front. Flush meaning it is flat. The two pieces are flat well. Then my one hand will hold this part so that it doesn't rotate with the screw, and then the other part will hold the machine. The machine has been well structured in a way that one hand can hold it well, and then I will screw again. I'll make sure that my machine is straight this way and also vertically straight that way, so that will come with experience, and with time you'll be able to achieve that. So we move now. I'll make sure I'm moving slowly and I'm achieving what I ought to achieve in screwing. A little speed, a bit of pressing. And then my screw is well fitted. So this piece of wood is not very hard. That is why I did not countersink. Countersinking meaning making a little bit of space for the head of the screw. The head of the screw needs to be to be accommodated in the wood. If the wood here is too hard, then it might not countersink for itself. But for this one, you may look at it, then it has gone a little bit down. The top part of it is flush. So I'll use the machine as well to fit this other longer screw. So this one is longer than the previous one. So I'll use the same technique I'll hold my machine straight, and then I'll screw it. I'll screw it. Now I don't have to hold the piece because it has been held by one screw. I will put my concentration now on the machine. I'll hold the machine upright and then move slowly, slowly, pressing a lot, pressing a lot. I press. So you can feel that sound. So it is not rotating. It is not rotating in the screw, around the screw here, but the motor is rotating. So the torque function of this machine is helping me in this sense. I will not overscrew. If I had not fitted that, or rather adjusted the torque, then it can either break the head of the screw or overscrew and make this screw not functional. It will not hold. But for now, if I want to reverse, I can reverse, put the reverse gear, and then reverse it, remove it. The tip here is a bit magnetic. That is why it can hold the screw. And then I can put it back, and then put it front, front direction, and then screw. So even if I go full speed, the torque will help me to regulate. Very good. Now it is well tightened. It is not overscrewed. So finally, I'll pick from my box here another one screw. And then I'll fit it here. I'll hold my machine right, well upright. And then I will drive it. I will drive it. So this one, you can see the head. The head is up here. So to fix that, I either countersink or I add the torque here. So to demonstrate the countersinking part of it, I will reverse this screw. I will remove it, then also remove this bit. Now the torque is limiting me to remove using the power of the machine. I'll regulate where there is no torque adjustment. Remove the torque, or rather the bit here, and fit a bigger bit. This bit, the front part of it here, will accommodate the head of the screw. So I'll reverse the machine, and then I'll hold it tight. I'll fasten the bit, and then just a little bit of some drilling up here. Slow speed, a little bit of drilling. Just that is enough. I have now countersunk for it. Then I'll put the other bit in place. It's now tight. Then I fit my screw. I'll put the torque adjustment so that it can adjust. I'll not overscrew. Then continue. Very good. Now my piece is well clamped. So let us have a look at it. So my clamps are very important. They help me hold my work when I'm doing it. So you can see my piece now, well fixed. It has three screws, so it's very well fixed. Now, if I need to remove it, I can remove it because it doesn't have glue. I did not glue it, and it is well fixed. It is tightly held. The screw is long enough. It has come all the way up to here. So it has held firmly, and I have piloted for the hole in the first part. So that is how to screw a piece of wood on another surface, most likely which is wooden. Now you may require to screw a wooden, or rather a metallic part on wood still. So here I have a piece of metal which is quite thick. It's a 2 millimeter, 2 millimeter metal piece. So 2 millimeter denotes the thickness of this piece of metal. So with this one, you have to drill it first. And we said this bit can be used either to drill into wood or to drill into metal. So in this case now, we are going to demonstrate the use of this bit to drill into metal. So I'll remove my piece now here that we have finished with. I'll remove. See how easy it becomes when you use technology in the right way. In less than a minute, I've removed the piece that I had fixed. So I'll put it aside, and then this piece of wood, I'll use it as a waste piece. So I'll clamp my piece of metal here with my clamp. The clamp can do that. I'll clamp the piece of metal there. Then I use this piece as a scrap wood, and I drill into the metal. So I'll remove the bit. I'll fit this bit that we said can drill either wood or metal. Now we used it to drill wood. Now we're going to drill into metal. So drilling, we said we put it in gear 2 here, up here, and then the front direction. Then I hold it. I'll mark my piece, of course, where I want the hole to be. Hold my drill upright, and then I will drill. That's simple. I now have a hole in my on my metal. I remove this bit. I fit a bigger bit to countersink, make room for the head of the screw. Because unlike metal, now here the screw cannot make its way into metal, the head of the screw. So I have to countersink. Countersink means using a bigger bit that will hold, that will accommodate the head of the screw. So countersink now. I have now made room for the screw head. So I'll fit this bit for screwing. Put gear number 1. And then use the screw that I desire now to hold the piece of metal into wood. I'll regulate the torque. And then I will screw it. Very good. Now I'm through. I've fitted a piece of metal into wood, and you can see it can't now fall. You may require to do that where you want to hang something on the wall. So if you want it to be a little bit flexible, now it is very tight, it can't move, and it only has one screw. So what I do, I can unscrew a little bit, and then it will be able to hang just that. You'll be able now to move. So with this now, you can have another hole here and hang something. Then you can have the convenience of it moving. If you don't want it to move, then you drill another hole here, put another screw. When there are 2 screws now, it can't move down here. But if you need it in a way it can rotate, you fix it like that. That's simple, and you spend a little bit of energy, of your energy, and then you'll be able to fix this piece of metal on a piece of wood, or even into another piece of metal. So these things are very important at home, because sometimes you want to fix something and you don't know, do I call a fundi? Now, how will he do it? When he comes, now he starts to suggest that you take this piece of wood to a, this piece of metal now to a metal welder. He will do it with the welding, the welding bit, and then it will not come out well. If you have the engineering bit and the machine, you can do it yourself. So for now, we have seen the importance and the use of this machine. So we want to take a short break, and once we are back, we'll be able to see more and more of these tools. So stay tuned.